been a while, huh? You know what's also been a while? Yeah. Anyway, today I'll be discussing the entire history of this game at the time of this upload. If at any point I miss something, do let me know in the comments down below. If you enjoyed this video at any point, consider subscribing, as it would mean a lot to me. Without further ado, let's dive right into it, because it will take a while. The year is 2013. Inazuma Go Galaxy Big Bang and Supernova just released in December for Japan. It is the final game of the Go franchise, featuring a lot of characters from the original era of games, Go characters, and a lot of scouts. A lot of the features from the previous installment returned, such as Keshins, Keshin Armed, and Miximax. It added a new mechanic, Souls. This was a gameplay mechanic that felt sort of like a Keshin Armed, where you could use regular special moves, but also a soul move. Instead of just depleting over time, souls would level up during the match, getting more powerful. This mechanic was used by the opponents all throughout the galaxy. Yeah, it's called Galaxy because its main setting is in space. You travel across different planets to battle aliens to win the Grand Celestial Galaxy, a tournament to decide which planet survives. Yeah, this is kind of a lot, isn't it? Inazuma 11 kept getting wilder and wilder with the last few installments. So what did they do? Well, they did nothing for a while. No new information on the next series or anything like that. For more than 2 years after the last episode of Galaxy aired in Japan. But after those 2 years, we finally got something in June of 2016. Information about this reveal was hard to find on anything but the Inazuma 11 wiki. But it talked about how the new series would begin on an island we didn't know much about at the time. It later talked about the regular setting of Inazuma 11 in Inazuma Town. It was revealed that this new chapter of Inazuma 11 would happen during the time of Endo's youth career, so not after Go or something like that. This was basically the first drop of information about a new game and anime, but more would be revealed a month later. In July, during the 2016 Level 5 Vision event, a huge announcement dropped. Yo-kai Watch for smartphones, baby! Wahoo! Sorry. What I meant to say is, the new Inazuma 11 series was announced, Inazuma 11 Ares no Tenbin. It was at this point we learned more about the story, with a full trailer and some details about what would be released relating to this new season. Obviously, an anime season would be released. It was revealed there will be three different main characters, Asato, Hisaki, and Nosaka, but they don't share the same team. The mysterious island that was shown off a month before reappears, as this is where the new main team lives at the start. Bako play for Ryman as their football field gets destroyed. They join the football frontier to keep playing football, but face off against the strong Seishu. At the end, we also learn about Inazuma 11 Outer Code, a series of short animations that happened before Ares, but after the original Season 1. This seems like a good time to mention that Ares is an alternate version of Season 2. In this world, all the events of Season 2, and some even before, never happened, as we can tell from Fubuki, Atsuya being alive, and the aliens being from a school named Eisei. The first one about Fubuki was teased in the trailer and released in late 2016, the others following later. Besides the anime, we got confirmation that the game would be coming, along with some merch, such as the 11 band. The anime was aimed to release in the summer of next year, 2017, and the game did not have a time period attached to it yet. It was nice to know about what was coming, but we didn't have any information about what the game would be like. Even the consoles were not known at the time. We had no clue what the game would be like, and didn't get much information for a while. How much is a while, you might ask? Well, we got the first bit of gameplay not in 2016, but in late 2017. It was October when Hino first showed actual gameplay footage of the game. The scheduled anime release wasn't met, so we at least knew something about the game before the anime was released, but it took a long time. Hino showed this footage during an Inazuma Walker stream. For those who don't know, Akihiro Hino is the CEO of Level 5, and he'll come back later several times, as he posted a lot of information about the game. Inazuma Walker were live shows in which Level 5 released a lot of information about the game. This first bit of gameplay shows how the football will look like in-game. The platform for the games were also announced. It will be released on the Nintendo Switch, PlayStation 4, and iOS and Android devices. This is why it doesn't look like any of the DS and 3DS games, as they won't be released on there. we were able to see how passing and shooting would work. More about the anime was also revealed during this broadcast of Inazuma Walker, so everything seemed to be going well. The game would even release in the summer of 2018, Hino stated during the blog, and was later reflected on the website. The first trailer was even released several months later, featuring more gameplay, not just matches either, but also things such as the overworld environment. It even showed a fire tornado being used in a match. Everything seemed to be going well and all. We even got this epic artwork of the game. But then, it happened. The month is June in 2018. The anime was currently already airing in Japan. But with the release date sneaking up as summer was rapidly approaching, the game was delayed a little bit. It would be pushed to fall of the same year. But it's a heavy blow. During an Inazuma 11 Walker stream, it was announced that the game would be playable during the WHF, the World Hobby Fair, of summer 2018. However, now that the game was delayed, the demo was cancelled. We steadily learned more and more about the game via the site getting updated. In July, we were shown the recruitment part of the game, similar to the first Inazuma 11 game. More details about gameplay, of how defending and command duos work, and more in-detail information about how passing and shooting work. More Zatsu techniques were also shown off, and most interesting is that Kori no Ya is a dribble move. A later update let us know about how override Zatsus work. They will require a teammate to know a specific move to be able to use the original move. We also got shown images of how different the Zatsus look in-game, and some in-game stadiums. While these updates to the site are happening, we saw the first details about the next season, Inazuma 11 Ori no Kukuin. The next era of Inazuma 11 was already planned, but we didn't even have a real date yet for the next game. However, it was revealed in early September that Inazuma 11 Ares would be playable at the Tokyo Game Show 2018 later that month. At the Tokyo Game Show, a trailer was shown, mostly about gameplay we had already seen before, and the demo was a short match against Seishu. Even though we knew so much more about the game now, there wasn't a more precise date given yet. The Tokyo Game Show started on the first day of fall, so its planned release window was here, but we knew nothing more. So what happened next wasn't shocking. Another delay was announced, and just like last time, it would be the next season once again. It was really sad to hear about another delay. I'm not saying it's a bad thing to give a game a little bit more time in the oven, but it does need to come out at some point. Several delays, one after another, isn't good for the morale, but at least we kept getting more updates on the site. The delay was issued for the reason that they wanted to improve the quality. This was nice, as during the Tokyo Game Show, many people reported drops in frame rates during certain Zatsus. However, it's October now. The last episode of the anime had already aired, and the Orion season had already started. Never has a new season of the anime been released before the previous game was released, so this was concerning to say the least. A new trailer was released, but it was very similar to the previous one we saw at the Tokyo Game Show. When researching for this part, I even thought it was the exact same trailer, but has some minor differences, like Norica using a blue god hand. Online multiplayer was confirmed during this trailer, as at the end, it says that multiplayer requires a Nintendo Switch Online subscription. We didn't know what kind of online functionality would be present, but we knew it would be there. A few weeks later, a new demo was even announced. Again during the WHF, but this time in winter 2019. Things are looking up, you might think, but look at the chapter we're in. Yeah. Hino announced that he will be announcing the release date on December 25th. It was said that the game would release in winter of this year, but considering the fact that you're in this chapter of the video, I think you know what's coming. In a video that is now private, Hino talked for 15 minutes about what happened during the development that caused this. Inazuma 11 Ares was rushed to be able to work on Orion, so I wanted it to line up with the World Cup. To achieve this goal, an external team was hired to help with working on the game. Inazuma 11 Ares was, however, a big project, and the team didn't have enough employees to make this project work. Hino tried getting more level 5 employees to work on the project, but said it wasn't enough. Now, level 5 is working with a different studio for development of this game. The earliest possible release Hino gave us is May of 2019, but he says it will probably be delayed once more and do not expect it in May. Hino also gave him some good news. with the game getting content from the original series and maybe even some Orion content later down the line. With this, he stated that the name Inazuma 11 Ares wouldn't make sense, so it might change later. The future of these games looks very unclear now. We don't know when the game will come out and what the game exactly will look like, but it's nice to know they're tackling the problem and letting us know the reason and their approach. A month later, WHF rolled around and had a little demo with the match against Zeus, telling us more about how the match would play out. The game still had slowdown issues apparently, but we learned that more Zatsus such as Tsunami Ball would be there. But this news is peanuts compared to this next bit. Short haired Osaka. On March 28th, 2019, Hino released his first developer blog post. This blog would aim to share the current state of the game. The first post talked about command duels without Zatsus, how they tried using a system where you can decide where to go. For the next while, all updates revolving around the game were via the blog, but other information about things such as Inazuma 11 SD, a different mobile game, was also revealed. But that won't be talked about in this video, cause it's already pretty long. I'll also speed through the first couple of blog posts. Post 2 is the one that showed off Short Haired Osaka. Post 3 talked about the UI, and more about command duels. Post 4 talked about cancellation of the event at the WHF of summer 2019, and some dialogue. Post 5 talked about making the previous cutscene better. The next post, post number 6, talked about the overworld. And that was it for a while. But then, at the Tokyo Game Show, a trailer was released. I couldn't find footage of this trailer, but from sources I've read, it didn't show much off, so it might be an old trailer. But it still says 2019 for its release date. This is in September, mind you, and this trailer wasn't even talked about by Level 5, but by Sony. This was very strange, but we must move on. And move on everything did, because the end of the Orion season was upon us. And on that day, Hino gave us some more news. But more news brought more delays. The game would be delayed until spring of the next year, 2020. This is because Level 5 made the decision to fully develop the game in-house, meaning it would no longer be partially outsourced to other studios. The game also finally got a name change. Inazuma 11 Great Road of Heroes was the new name, and it sounds awesome. More and bigger ideas, like more characters, are planned for the game. The site, however, was left behind. It didn't see a change to reflect this new approach and title. On December 25th of 2019, it finally changed, and the change was disappointing. I couldn't find how the whole site looked, but the only new thing was a single piece of art. You know, site not updating for a while, it's weird, but no big deal. We would soon get more information about the game, if you define soon as 4 months. All jokes aside, there wasn't very much news, until the 1st of April 2020, when a new blog post dropped. It starts pretty sad, with the fact that Hino was considering giving up on this project, as there was a lot of backlash from critical fans. He did not give up, however, due to some supportive people who helped him. After that, Hino talks about his plan. Due to not being tied to the anime's release schedule anymore, he will try to create a game with a lot of freedom in it, and make it the culmination of all of Inazuma 11. With this, a new character was revealed. The new main character, Unmei Sasanami. The blog states he is a manager that loves football, but doesn't play it due to a trauma. This will put the focus on the whole team, as you look through the perspective of a manager, Hino states. The game will feature all three protagonists from the anime, Endo, Tenma, and Asto, and not be bound to a specific era of Inazuma 11. At the end, Hino apologizes for the delay and he says he thinks that the game will be released in 2021. This was good news, but we all know how 2020 went, with that one thing I really don't want to talk about right now. Anyway, the months went by without any real news about Inazuma 11 Great Road of Heroes. But then, in September, Hino posted a tweet stating the following: Inazuma 11 Great Road of Heroes has been reprioritized. The higher priority has been given to the development of the new Yo-Kai Watch game. I don't know much about Yo-Kai Watch, but this game needed to line up with the anime release, from what I could find. This made the release date of 2021 more unlikely, but it was still 2020 at the time, so who knows? We just had to wait and see, and wait we had to do. Months flew by without news. When the new year rolled around, we didn't even have news revolving around the game. Several months went by and we still had nothing. On the 1st of April, it marked the 1 year period of having no real news. How much longer did we have to wait to learn more about the state of the game? Well, we only had to wait a single day, because on the 2nd of April 2021, a blog post was dropped that was accompanied by a video. It is a 4-minute video where Hina talks about the state of the game and some gameplay in the background. The most important takeaway from this video is that we can now jump in the overworld. Inazuma 11 is so back. Also, I guess it's sort of important to mention that they're aiming for a 2023 release. Their goal is to make it a combination of all the season, enforced by the fact that we can see characters from every season. There will be single and multiplayer. And lastly, aiming to recreate the gameplay like on the DS and 3DS. A lot of information in a nice video. We've waited for a long time, but everything is looking promising right now. They've still given themselves a lot of time by aiming for a release in 2023, which I think is good. He also apologized for the wait, which is fair. A year without any news is a long time, so surely they wouldn't do it again, right? Right? I jinxed it, huh? Damn. We waited a year with no update on the game. It was April 2022, but we were nothing wiser than before. 2023 was creeping up, and they didn't tell us anything. But maybe like last time, we would only need to wait a couple more days. Why is it so quiet? Did I jinx it again? Okay, April didn't give us anything, and neither did May and June. However, in July, Hino sent a particular tweet announcing that next week we would get another development block, with artwork of Unmei and some unknown new character. Who was he, and what will we learn about the game? Well, next week, on July 21st, a new blog post was released, and boy was it a good one. First things first, the name Inazuma 11 Great Road of Heroes is no more. It is now Inazuma 11 Victory Road, to reflect the new characters, as how they're not yet great. There's a new logo as well, and we got this artwork with more mysterious characters in the background. There will be two different modes in the game, the regular story mode, focusing on the story of Unmei, and a chronicle mode. This mode is where you can battle past teams and recruit past players of said teams. The idea of the story will focus on Unmei, who loves football, but can't play football. It was confirmed the story would play out at a different school, and some images were shown for that. Lastly, the control scheme was also talked about. It was confirmed that you could play the game like you did on the 3DS or DS, with touchscreen controls, but it's optional, as you can choose to use a controller as well. The game will allow you to freely switch control schemes, and it can be played horizontally or vertically. That was all the news, basically, but at the end, Hino said to expect more news around the end of the year. We got so many images and a way more clear view of what the game is trying to be. This was very exciting, and the hype for Victory Road was real. While waiting for more news, nothing happened, so we had to sit and wait patiently for more news. But at the end of 2022, as promised, more news in the form of a blog post with a video was released. This blog didn't have much new information, but it showed off how to control an actual football of the game would look like. I think they wanted to show off they were able to have the older 3DS control scheme while also being able to play with a controller. They used the Switch as an example and showed a lot of ways how you can play, plus some minor gameplay details like pausing. The video ends with this beautiful artwork that is still used. You've probably seen this one before, and it shows off all the old protagonists, the new one Unmei, and a lot of other characters, old and new alike. The last part of the video shows us there will be more news in February of 2023, so only 2 months from when the blog post was released. The blog also gave us some information that was not in the video, and it shows off new artwork of a never-before-seen character, whose name is unknown. It is revealed he is one of the top football players, and the story was changed to include this character. The story was changed in such a way to reflect the success of Unmei, but also the suffering of being at the top. But that concludes this blog post. While it was a smaller one, it showed a lot of promise, as the gameplay looked solid. The next information, that was supposed to be out in February, got pushed back to March, Hino tweeted out. It will be part of the Level 5 Vision event, which will take place on March 9th. Level 5 Vision was a livestream in which they would announce information for the upcoming events related to Level 5. This being part of Level 5 Vision probably meant they would have a lot of information coming our way. And boy did we get a lot of information. The event lasted half an hour, and the last item shown was information on Inazuma 11 Victory Road. It opened with this beautiful yet epic scene, featuring this unknown character from last time. But well, he isn't unknown anymore. In the video, they reveal who he is, and his name is Endo Haru, descendant of Endo Mamoru. But before this, they tell us a little bit about the setup of the plot. It also lets us know the name of presumably the new rival. His name is Suruga Yagyu, and he is seen with a baseball bat to indicate he probably doesn't actually play football. It then shows off 5v5 battles with a lot of new characters from the game. Their names are now known as well. From left to right, there's Sakurazaki, Shisendo, Kisoji, Shinohara, and Kodokai. Sorry if I butchered those names. But this part also shows off the controls, just like last video. After that, we get more information about how Chronicle Mode will work with 4,500 characters. It'll be like a competition route, accessible from the Inazuma Caravan. By doing Chronicle Mode, you'll unlock stars you can use to recruit players. These players will appear in what's known as the Player Universe. And after that, they will appear in the Bond Alley, where you can actually get them to join after completing some requirements. Sort of like PAL packing. After that, it talks about online compatibility, confirming the game will have online matches. Even a new unnamed Zatsu is shown off. But the most important thing, in my opinion, is the English logo for the game. This, to me, confirms that the game will be released outside of Japan as well, which was never confirmed before this. That is the trailer, but afterwards, Ino says during the stream that there will be more cutscenes to enhance the story than ever before, and they're made by the animation studio MAPPA. Also, more information will be posted on the blog that day. But that concludes Level 5 Vision, and wow, was it a good one. We learned so much, and we weren't even done with the information for today yet. Since the blog not only shares more art, but also information on how things were developed, and some things not told during the presentation. The story takes place 25 years after Inazuma 11 1. You will not be playing for Ramon, but for Nagumohara, which is not near Inazuma Town, so it will be a unique environment. Ramon will, in fact, be the final opponent for you to beat. Ino did this as he viewed Ramon as the strongest team, because they always managed to beat any challenge. But Ramon will also have their fair share of problems this time. The blog also confirmed a worldwide release that will happen at the same time everywhere. Lastly, more information will be coming in the summer, and that's how the blog post ends. Wow, what a lot of information to take in. Everything is looking really good, so this is a promising sign of things to come. I love the look of the new characters, and Chronicle Mode looks super fun, as I've always liked competition routes in other games. Anyway, later in March, an interview was released, and it didn't give us much new information. However, Hino was considering making a short anime based on Victory Road, but nothing has officially been decided yet. This would be really cool if you ask me. If MAPPA worked on this project, the same team that helped with the first cutscene of the trailer, it would probably be breathtaking. This was all the news for a bit, as the next news wouldn't be released directly by Hino or Level 5, but instead by ambassadors. These ambassadors are people not directly related to Level 5, but are responsible for promoting Level 5 games, and in this case, promoting Inazuma 11. They have meetings every once in a while with Level 5, in which they get to learn more about the game, and then they relay the information back to us. This first meeting, that happened in May of 2023, didn't reveal much new. They showed us a message from Hino, and some art for players and environments. We have seen most of these things before, but not in official artwork form, so that's nice at least. About 3 months later, in August, another ambassador meeting happened, and this time we did learn some new information. We got new artwork of an unknown character whose name has intentionally been left out by Hino, as he is related to a certain known character, but we don't know who yet for sure. The other news is that there will be more news on August 22nd, only 2 days after this drop of information. Lastly, and this is a big one, at the Tokyo Game Show 2023, Inazuma 11 Victory Road will be a playable demo there. This is really nice to know, as we can feel what the game is like, and not just see it. We haven't had a demo since the rebrand. Anyway, let's talk more about the demo when we get to it. And now talk about the new information from the blog post. First things first, this blog post is fully available in English on their site, which makes me happy, as they're really trying to interact with not just the Japanese fans, but also overseas fans. But let's dive into the meat of the matter. With new mechanics for the football matches, this will be showcased in a trailer for the Tokyo Game Show, but we got explained how they would work. The new mechanics are focus, which seems to be picture above, as how you can engage in the midfield, in the zone, which happens when players are near any of the goals for what to do next. Scramble seems to be about accepting passes and deciding what to do with them. And lastly, the tension gauze, which is the new way to use Hisatsu that builds up over time and is shared with the whole team. Next up, they talk about something very exciting, a tournament mode. This seems to be their plan for long-term content for the game, and it sounds really good. It will last a couple of months and then rotate the players you can use. They say details may change, but this seems to be the basic outline for the game mode. Next up, voice actors have been chosen for Unmei and Haru. Who they are, we don't know yet, but it is said that Haru at least sounds like the son of Endu, which is cool. Next up, they intend to add Kenshin from the very start of the game's release, but not Miximax and Kenshin Armed. They do not mention Souls directly, but it is implied to go along with Miximax and Kenshin Armed, as they say certain features. The plan is probably to add them in an update or DLC patch, but this is not confirmed. Lastly, we learn about the release of more news on the last day of August, and right before the Tokyo Game Show. This is a bunch of news, and the tournament mode sounds very exciting. There are three modes now, and there seems to be something for everyone. An offline story mode, an offline battle mode, and an online battle mode. It seems they're trying to balance the game by not allowing players to be very much overleveled. Which is exciting, because previously the best teams were pretty standardized. But let's move on to the next blog post, with a little trailer on the last day of August, in which we can see the mechanics talked about last time. It is playing in the background, and we now have a better understanding of how the aforementioned new mechanics can be used and what they're like. We now know, for example, that during in the zone, that the game will slow down to make a precise shot or to pass to a teammate. However, a lot of new information comes from the team screen, which was never shown before. It let us know about passive skill players will have, and a potential rarity system, as next to Endo it says legendary player. This blog didn't let us know that much, but this period is full of information, as in the blog it states we'll get to learn more about the story in mid-September. The promise of more information about the stories also sounds really nice. I want to know more about the characters, and I want them to protect Kisoji at all costs. Anyway, on the 16th of September, a new blog post rolled around, featuring a beautiful 4-minute trailer. I will play it without audio in this video, but it features great voice acting and a new banger song from T-Pistons, so I highly recommend checking out this trailer. We learn a bit more about Unmei. The trailer and blog describe him as sinister, with him saying, "Why can't soccer disappear from the face of the earth?" With him not being able to play football, the protagonist is different than ever before, and it excites me. Next up, we learn a bit more about the side characters from Unmei's new school. But I want to move on to Endo Haru, who hits us with the line, "Isn't soccer kind of boring?" Which you wouldn't expect from Endo's literal son. The blog says this is due to his natural talent, so he doesn't understand the feelings of those who put in the work to be good at football. Unmei and Haru are complete opposites of each other, so it'll be interesting to see how it pans out. The blog confirms they'll also be playing each other in the very first match of the game, but also in the finals. Also, can we take a look at this new character, Ren Tsukikage, the captain of Raimon? He looks cool and that's all. Hell, even the rest of the team looks cool. In the rest of the trailer, more of the areas get shown off for the story mode. We see a bit more about Chronicle mode, which still looks how it originally looked, and we see a bit more gameplay. But nothing new except for that unknown Izatsu we saw earlier now, having a name, being Shunrai. We get to see more about the online tournament for this new screen, and that is it for information. But we also see a really cool cutscene at the end of Unmei and Sakurazaki, and we learn this game will also be released for the PlayStation 5. This trailer was really good and I loved it. It was really well put together and let us learn about the game, but also did a good job showing off points from previous videos for those who haven't watched those. At the end of the blog, Hino mentions that a release date will be announced as soon as possible. However, the development is slower than expected. That isn't to say they're doing badly, however, because in his own words, development is going smoothly. But Hino wants to deliver something perfect, so there's no official release date yet. This game is still planned for 2023. However, with no real release date in September, another delay seems likely. But the game seems to be going really well. The next blog post is a small one. It offers very little text, but it does give us a 6-minute video. It is basically a tutorial on how to play the game for the upcoming demo, but also explains some details about what will be in the final game and is absent from the demo. Most systems are in place, but a bit smaller in numbers, such as the amount of Hisatsus and the amount of defending during the in-the-zone mechanic. But one thing is absent from the demo, and that is the Keeper Gauge. It basically works like the Keeper Gauge from the recent Go games, where you can score if you deplete the bar. That is all for this blog post really, but September is still full of information. More will be released during the Tokyo Game Show, but all that information is also compiled into a blog post that Hino posted in October. Here, the main points from a live Inazuma 11 walker will be noted. It had 6 points on how the game would be playable for a long time. The first one mentioned was being able to keep every player you scout out. In the older titles, you had a limit to how many players you can keep, but not in this game. The second is having several rarities for each player, so once you get a player once, it's not the end. The third point is to have interesting abilities that can have really good synergy with one another to keep team building fun and exciting. The fourth point is difficulty options after you beat a match for the first time, allowing you to replay a team several times but make it more challenging. The last two points relate to online play and online competitions. Each will have a unique rule set that will allow and disallow certain players. I think this blog post is really nice to have because I enjoy Inazuma 11 games, but there is just a limit to how much you can really do in the game. With only local battles and battle versus AI like the other 3DS games did, once you had beaten all the competition routes, the game was really over. Without difficulty settings, once you had beaten the highest level team in the competition route, the game was a piece of cake. I remember in Inazuma 11 3 building a team I really liked, but then being so overleveled, the game became less fun, and I just beat the teams for the sake of beating them. With this, offline matches and team building will always be fun, and the online battles add even more playtime to the game. This is the last piece of information for September. In October had nothing to. But in November, a tweet was posted that confirms another level 5 vision stream that will feature Inazuma 11 Victory Road with release date. This is very exciting, and it will happen on the 29th of November. Whether this release date will be met or not, we would just have to wait and see, but just the promise of that is very exciting. We'd probably learn a lot about the game too, since if we're getting a release date, it means the game is near completion. But let's move on to the trailer. It was accompanied by a blog post. I personally think it's less impressive than the previous trailer we got. It started with some basic gameplay, but we do learn that some older mechanics, such as shot chains and shot blocks, return. These were never confirmed to come back, so it's nice to know that these are coming back. We then see events from the story mode, such as Nagumo Hara joining the football frontier. However, the ending is the best part, as it announces that there will be an open worldwide beta in March of 2024. It will feature a bit of every mode, but level 5 will use the feedback to improve the game. The demo is only available on the Nintendo Switch, probably to also get feedback on the control options. For the story mode, we get Chapter 1. The amount of chapters has never been confirmed as far as I could find, but it's fair to expect only up to the first match at the maximum. For online battles, you'll need to play matches versus randoms and matches versus your friends in private lobbies. It will also feature character progression. Chronicle mode isn't named Chronicle mode on this final screen, rather single player, probably indicating some other form of online battles will be available. It will have team and difficulty selection. In the last image of the video, we see all the features that will be in Victory Road. But I'm at page 9 of my script, so I won't go into detail yet. Just pause here if you want to take a good look. One thing to point out is that the game doesn't have a release month yet, but it will release in 2024. In the blog, Hino talks about why a beta and not a release, and that is that he wants the game to be as good as possible. He needs us for this reason, to test the game and submit feedback. They also released another video, which is about a strategy. Here, Ume talks to Haru about his strategy for a new team, Eastwind Perigee. This meeting is to put emphasis on the importance of strategy in this game, which I like. Another thing this trailer did was tease the name of some new Hisatsus. Hino stated earlier in the blog, he wants the game to not only be about pure skill in the action elements, but also team building. That was the blog, and wow, I am so happy to know a beta test is coming our way. I think it's a way better idea to release a beta first and delay the game slightly than to release the game a bit early without a beta. Now, we get to try out the game for ourselves, which is incredibly hype. The amount of content also appears to be a lot due to having online battles. This will allow people to extensively test out the gameplay. A bit after this trailer, we get more information from the ambassadors. The biggest thing, in my opinion, that we learn from the ambassadors is that we're getting a Steam release for the game. This means that the game will be able to be played on the PC, which, at least for me, is massive, since I don't have a capture card or something for my Switch. I'll actually be able to put out gameplay content for the game without making a purchase for that. I might finally buy a better mic with all that save money. Another point I want to highlight is that the lack of other story characters in the trailer is due to the fact that they're not set in stone. You can personally choose who to recruit as for the remaining members, just like in Inazuma Eleven 2, where you can choose the last couple of members for your team. Another thing that was mentioned was one of the features from the end of the last trailer we didn't know much about was revealed. In short, there will be a skill tree called Ability Board. Lastly, there was talk of a possibility of remakes of the original DS Inazuma Eleven games for Switch. It will be a remake of Inazuma Eleven 1, 2, 3, which is a compilation for the 3DS of the original games. I think this would be cool, because personally, I think these games are still solid after all these years. But that is all the news up until now, at least until the time of writing the script. So let's move on to what the future will hold. At the time of making this video, more information was released about the available players in the demo, and an ambassador meeting happened that talked about how the beta will be up until the release of the actual game. Level 5 might release more information while making this video that I won't cover, but check the pinned comment if there's more news before the release of this video. What do I think of the future of this game is? Well, it currently looks very bright for the game. I am very excited for the beta test and will play it and probably cover it. I personally think there won't be any additional information released until the beta. When do I think the final release will be released? Well, I don't have a clue. I think Level 5 will first respond to the feedback of the beta, and then a bit after that, post a release date. But this is all speculation. I'm happy to say that Inazuma Eleven is finally back. If you're still here, and wondering why there was such a lack of uploads, check out my community post I made a while back ago. I am back now because I want to play Victory Road, and I made this video because I wanted to compile all the information in its process. I was personally really just excited to learn about the game. There will be links in the description down below for all the sources I used chronologically in the video. But I want to give an extra big shout out to Inazuma Frontier, a site that posts articles about every bit of news covering the entire Inazuma 11 franchise, and Reddit user VikingDog78, who has a really nice post about the history of the game too. But that is all for this video. So thanks for watching, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I hope you all have a great day. Goodbye.